I'm Laura, and I'm on the Chrome accessibility team at Google. In this video, I'm going to show you the basic steps for navigating your Chromebook using the ChromeVox screen reader. After this video, you should know enough about ChromeVox to read web pages, explore your Chromebook screen, and find additional resources. If you've used the previous version of ChromeVox, now known as ChromeVox Classic, you'll find some things have changed. For the biggest differences in the new version, which was officially released in Chrome version 56, be sure to watch our introductory video about transitioning between the two versions. For reference, Chrome 56 reached the Chrome OS stable channel at the end of January 2017. For this video, though, you don't need to have any prior experience with ChromeVox, so let's get started. ChromeVox comes built into every Chrome OS device, so there's nothing to install. All you need to do to turn on the screen reader is hold down Ctrl and Alt and press the letter Z, as in zebra. For reference, there are two sets of Ctrl and Alt keys on your Chromebook keyboard. In the bottom left corner of the keyboard, there are the two keys to the left of the spacebar. Smaller versions are also found directly to the right of the spacebar before you reach the arrow keys. I'll go ahead and turn ChromeVox on now.
ChromeVox spoken feedback is ready.
By the way, this same shortcut, Ctrl-Alt-Z, also turns ChromeVox off. But I'll leave it on for now, otherwise this video wouldn't be very helpful. If you don't hear ChromeVox when you first turn it on, make sure that your speakers or headphones are plugged in and turned on. If you still don't hear anything, check that the volume is up on your Chromebook. The quickest way to do this is to press the volume up key, located second from the right at the top of the keyboard. Now let's talk about basic navigation. The search key on your Chromebook keyboard is what we call the ChromeVox modifier key. It works in combination with other keys on your keyboard to help you navigate. Most ChromeVox shortcuts begin with the search key, often referred to as the ChromeVox key, so this is a pretty important one to remember. First, let me open up a new Chrome tab to show you how this works. To do this, I'll use the browser shortcut Ctrl plus T for tab.
Tab created, address and search bar, edit text, main, toolbar, new tab, window.
Now, I hold down search and press the right arrow to move forward to the next object on the page.
Bookmark this page, Chrome button has pop up.
To go backward by object, I can press search or ChromeVox.
Main, toolbar.
Plus the left arrow.
Chrome button has pop up. Bookmark this page, button.
This is called linear navigation, moving item to item on the page. Before we continue exploring other ways to navigate, I think it's important to show you the ChromeVox Learn Mode. If the Chromebook keyboard is somewhat new to you, the Learn Mode can be really helpful as you learn the layout. To enter this mode, I hold down Search and press O and then K, as an open keyboard. This opens up a new Chrome tab. Let's take a look. When Learn Mode is on, I can press the keys on my Chromebook to hear what they are. I'll press a few keys now.
H, A, U, 7, 4, enter, single quote.
I can also press various key combinations to hear what the individual keys are and to hear any shortcuts that they make. For example, let's see what happens when I press search and B, as in boy, together.
Search, B, next button.
I hear the key names and also that this key combination is the command for moving to the next button. Note that this mode also works well when typing on a connected USB Braille display. This can be a helpful learning tool as you begin typing with Braille. To exit Learn Mode, press the shortcut to close the browser tab, which is Ctrl-W. Now let's continue exploring different ways to navigate the screen. In addition to navigating the page linearly using search plus right or left, I can also use jump commands to skip forward or backward between similar page items, such as from one heading to the next, link to link, between form fields, and more. I'm going to show you just a few of the most common ones for now. I'll hold down search and press the letter key for the type of item I want to jump to. Let's start with H for headings. For long pages, this is a great way to get a sense for what's on the page and to get to the topics I really want to read about. To show you, I'll open up a new Chrome tab by pressing Ctrl plus T.
Address and search bar, edit text, main, toolbar, new tab, window.
and type in the URL for our Google Accessibility site.
Unselect slash accessibility, select google.google accessibility, find guides and resources, heading 2, main.
Now, to navigate forward by headings on this page, I press search plus H.
Developers and publishers, link, heading 3, list item, list. Enterprise and business, link, heading 3, list item. Initiatives and research, link, heading 3, list item.
To navigate backwards, I press search plus shift plus H.
Enterprise and business, link, developers and publishers,
note that I can
link.
Press control to temporarily silence speech. This is definitely a handy key to remember. Here's a quick tip for you if you're an experienced screen reader user.
Initiatives and research, Google accessibility.
If you're on a long article or complex document that has lots of headings at different levels, remember that you can jump forward or backward by specific heading levels. For example, to jump forward only by items marked as heading level 3, I press search plus the number 3.
FCC Video Programming Accessibility Advisory Committee, VPAAC, heading 3, main.
To go backwards, it's search shift 3.
Project supported by Google, heading 3.
Now, let's try search plus L to jump forward by links on the page.
ASL STEM project, link, list item, list, with 3 items. Mobilisil via Android, link, list item. NAPPAL, mobile navigation aid for the visually impaired, link, list item.
And search shift L to jump backward.
Mobilisil via and ASL STEM Google research blog, link.
There are lots of different jump commands that will work like this, and I'll show you a way to find all of these commands later in this video. Let's talk about using the keyboard to access fundamental things like the Chrome address bar. I hold down Control and press L, as in location, and my cursor jumps to the address bar.
https://www.google.com/accessibility/selected.
From here, I can type a web address or search term and press Enter.
nn.com, select, omavox, mavox, avox, fox, subspace, h, arts, l, p, Chrome help, selected. HTTP, Chrome help, Google search, add get Google Chrome, sync Chrome across devices, add.
It's helpful to note that this is not a ChromeVox specific command. It's more generally a Chrome OS keyboard command. There are a handful of these Chrome OS keyboard commands to access the various parts of the screen, like the address bar, without the use of a mouse. These commands work regardless of ChromeVox being enabled. That said, there are a wide variety of ChromeVox specific commands, like navigational and jump commands, and these can all be found in the ChromeVox menus. This combination of Chrome OS keyboard commands with ChromeVox specific commands enables full non-visual access to the computer. Now I'd like to show you the ChromeVox menus I mentioned before. The ChromeVox menus are a new feature that'll make your ChromeVox experience more efficient. When ChromeVox is on, you can open the ChromeVox menus by pressing search plus period.
ChromeVox panel, jump, menu. Click on current item ChromeVox plus space, menu item, 1 of 59.
Once this is open, I press the arrow keys to move between the menu headings at the top of the screen. Here, I can navigate through a list of jump commands.
Go to beginning of the current column. Go to beginning of table ChromeVox plus alt plus shift plus left arrow, menu item.
Speech options.
Start speech, menu. Announce the title of the current page ChromeVox plus A greater than W, menu item, 1 of 15.
My open tabs,
tabs, menu, Google accessibility, active, menu item, 1 of 1,
and more ChromeVox options.
ChromeVox, menu, enable slash disable sticky mode CVOX, menu item, 1 of 10.
ChromeVox commands are grouped in different lists so I can access specific commands faster, like a list of headings on a given page, or the list of links, forms, tables, and ARIA landmarks. If a list is blank, that means that the page simply doesn't have any of that item. I can either use these menus as a reference and press Escape to close them, or I can find a specific command and then press Enter to activate it. This is a very useful tool when you are first learning ChromeVox, so you don't have to memorize a long list of commands right off the bat. You can use this feature to explore your options and learn the commands that you personally find most useful as you navigate. This next feature is called Sticky Mode. If I double tap the search key, I hear confirmation that Sticky Mode is enabled.
Sticky Mode enabled.
With Sticky Mode on, I don't need to press the search key anymore. Earlier, to explore a page, I had to hold down search before pressing the right arrow. Now, I just press the right arrow because the search key is now considered sticky, as if I'm still pressing it.
Initiatives and research. Heading. Google's support of accessibility extends beyond products to include research, education, and design efforts.
Same goes for the jump commands. Before, remember that I had to press search plus H to navigate forward by headings? Now I can just press the letter H.
Our approach to accessibility, heading 2. Accessible web initiatives, heading 2.
Keep in mind that if you want to write text in an editable field, you'll want to turn sticky mode off. To turn it off, I double tap the search key again.
Sticky mode disabled.
Remember, you have to double tap quickly. ChromeVox will tell you when you've turned sticky mode on or off, so be sure to listen for it. Next, let's adjust the speech settings for ChromeVox. We can change the pitch and the speech rate, and also choose a different language. If ChromeVox is speaking too slowly, I can increase the rate by holding down search and pressing the left bracket key. The left bracket key is directly to the right of the letter P, as in Paul, on the Chromebook keyboard.
Rate 25%. Rate 27%.
To slow the speech down, I hold down search plus shift plus the left bracket key.
Rate 25%. Rate 23%.
Next, I'll change the pitch of the voice. To make ChromeVox speak at a higher pitch, I hold down search and press the right bracket.
Pitch 50%, pitch 56%, pitch 61%.
To have the voice speak at a lower pitch, I hold down search plus shift plus the right bracket.
Pitch 56%, pitch 50%, pitch 44%.
Finally, let's discuss one more option, changing the language. When you first set up your Chromebook and choose a native language, it automatically applies to ChromeVox as well. To change it, I need to open up the ChromeVox options page. To do this, I hold down search and press O and then O again, as in Open Options. This will open up in a new Chrome tab. Now I can use search plus right to navigate to the Voices section and choose a language.
Chrome OS US English. Change the current voice by selecting an option from the list below. Button has pop-up collapsed. Chrome OS US English. Menu item 11 of 13. Chrome OS US English. Chrome OS UK English. Chrome OS Português do Brasil. Chrome OS Netherlands. Menu item 8 of 13. Chrome OS Netherlands. Menu item 8 of 13. Chrome OS. Chrome OS US English.
To close the options page, press Ctrl W. That's all for now. Let's wrap up with how to get more information or send us feedback. For general feedback or questions on any of the topics you've seen today, go to groups.google.com and search for the public group ChromeVox-discuss. If you join the group, then you can send emails to ChromeVox-discuss@googlegroups.com and participate in the conversation with our team and other users. You can also send feedback about any issues you're having directly from your Chromebook. With ChromeVox enabled, press search plus A and then I, as in add input, to open up a feedback report, fill out the relevant details, and then submit. Also, look out for more videos about ChromeVox and other ways to make Chrome and Chromebooks easier to use. Again, I'm Laura, and on behalf of myself and the Chrome Accessibility team, thanks for watching. I definitely recommend checking out our other videos about ChromeVox and about navigating your Chromebook by keyboard. Also, make sure to subscribe to the channel.